So here I am at the Assiniboine Park. I'm gonna go for a walk, and I thought I would film no snow. They're predicting a 20 to 30 centimeter snowstorm. They call it a Colorado low. It's a low pressure zone that builds up the 49th parallel or something like that. I was reading the weather forecast. So I'm speaking against it, telling it to go in the name of Jesus. The Assiniboine Zoo parking lot on November 9th at around 5 p.m. That's my cube that I won from Greg Zabel. The Lord told me I would win it, and I did. Thank you, Jesus. There's the zoo sign and a plane coming in. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Looking to the southwest, command that storm system to bow down and stop. Low pressure, leave. Clouds, stop building up. Snow, stop building up. Precipitation, snow, precipitation, stop. Hold up your precipitation. Hold up the storehouses of snow for more time. I just don't want the snow. I don't like it. I'm sorry, I just don't. But anyway, this is my documentary. Christopher Hussar, speaking to the weather systems, by faith in the name of Jesus Christ and the authority in the name of Jesus Christ. Snowstorm, bow down. Do not come to Winnipeg. Do not come to the prairies. Jesus' name. This is a new entrance, I guess, maybe, for the zoo. It's not open yet, it looks like. Well, maybe it is. But there's no signs or nothing other than who created it, built it. But, alright. Chris, over and out. Snowstorms be gone. I got my toque on. So anyway, be blessed. Jesus loves you, sons and daughters, and those who don't know him. He wants you to come to repentance. Turn from your sin to receive his forgiveness, his righteousness, his grace to live holy and pure. And he will do it in you. If you turn to him, he'll give you a new heart, a new nature, his nature. And you will live holy and do the things that he did. And he won't be perfect. I know I'm not perfect. I fall, but he's gracious. And he says through the Holy Spirit, through John, 1 John 1:9, that if we sin and confess our sins to him, he is faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He is good, and he is purifying his sons and daughters. He's sanctifying them for the work of ministry here on earth, preparing us to proclaim the kingdom, and that it is at hand. It is here and now. The entryway is through Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, and the life. Only through him do we get to the Father. So call on his name, you will be saved. Proclaim him as Lord in your life. Trust him. Turn from your sin. And believe. Believe, and he will give you a new nature. He will give you forgiveness. He will give you eternal life. Eternal life begins when you believe and you become born again. Your spirit becomes one spirit with him. He lives in you. He will get baptized in water, submersion, signifying our death to sin and our resurrection in him. And it's a public profession of our inward faith, an outward public testimony of our inward faith toward God, toward Jesus Christ and his saving grace. And he'll baptize you in the Holy Spirit, giving you power to be a witness, that you will lay hands on the sick, they will be healed. He will raise the dead. He will cast out devils, cleanse lepers, and be a son and daughter. He predestined you for adoption to sonship. Those who come to him and believe become children of Abraham through faith. So in Jesus' name, I admonish each one of you watching this, come to the Lord Jesus. He wants you to know him. He wants to walk with you. And he is good. He is awesome. There is going to be a day when every one of us will face him and answer for the things done in the body, whether good or bad. We all face him. And if we have him as our Lord and our righteousness, our Savior, then we will not be answering for the wrong that we've done, but we'll be answering for the things that we did that were right. And those who do not have him as Lord and Savior, he will judge righteously through Jesus Christ. And I'm going across the road here. He will cast the unbelievers, the unrighteous people, the fornicators and adulterers and murderers and sodomites, homosexuals, and whatever else is evil and does not come to him, into the lake of fire forever with the devil and his angels, which he prepared for them. So this is the Sri Chinmoy Peace Mile. I walk this a lot. Everywhere I go is peace. It's funny, because this is called the Peace Mile, and then I go to work, and I walk along this path for breaks and lunches, and it's called the Path to Peace. There's a statue of Gandhi, but I bring the Prince of Peace. I pray for people sometimes there, and they get healed, and get the message of the gospel preached to them, and God is so good. I love it. Oh, I just love it. I get goose pimples right now just thinking about how good he is, and then just, well, his presence, he's on me and in me. And I'm going to stop talking now. But anyway, here's pre-snow, snow go. I pray for people here too. He heals people along this path and in the park, and a few people's legs growing out and backs healed, and different things. It's just awesome. This is called the Assiniboine Forest. They have lots of deer in here. Oh yeah, I was going to stop the video. Anyway, God bless you all. Believe and receive eternal life in Jesus Christ. He is good. He's Lord. Hallelujah. He's coming again one day for his bride, who is made pure as he is pure. Amen. Okay, bye.